Forced labor is a sensitive topic between South Korea and Japan, as the latter continues to attempt to hide what really happened and fails to recognize its wrongdoings. So on Wednesday, an international forum was held in capital of Seoul, inviting experts across the globe to call for Japan's to right its wrongdoings. Our Kim Do-yeon with more.
Japan broke its commitment to the truth when the Industrial Heritage Information Center in Tokyo opened last month without any exhibitions on forced labor. In response, an international forum was held on Wednesday by the Asia Peace and History Institute and called for the country to put things right. At the Humanities Collective Memories UNESCO World Heritage and Trust in International Relations Forum, experts across the globe, including those from the U.S. and Japan, came together both in person and virtually to condemn Tokyo's hiding of the truth, distorting history, and only praising the Industrial Revolution.
Such an attitude is not only insincere, but also procedurally wrong. The Japanese government needs to reconsider the interpretation by allowing all parties involved, including victims and various researchers, to participate in the process.
Also in attendance was South Korea's Minister of Culture, Sports and Tourism, Park Yang-woo. After offering congratulatory remarks, the minister sat with foreign correspondents to converse and answer any questions.
So I, as the minister who hosts cultural events, am asking for the truth to be revealed and for Japan to keep the promise it made to the international community. Then I believe Japan can truly become a member of the cultural society.
Adding that trust stems from an honest and sincere attitude, Minister Park called on Japan to try and empathize with the victims and their families.
The experts here generally agreed that the goal isn't to cancel the Industrial Heritage Site's UNESCO status. Rather, it is purely to make sure the correct facts are displayed at the sites because we can often learn deeper lessons from the negative aspects of history. Kim Do-yeon, Arirang News.